island and we're the captain.
Hello.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Wow. A full theater of bored to death people. Hello? Όχι. Όχι. Είμαι στο θέατρο. Death. My wife. She wants to make sure that you know I am married. Yes? It does. Happily married.
it's the same joke.
Cannot please a woman.
It's the same joke all the time.
Well, since I have you all gathered here on a sunny day, I want to believe that I'm damn good. There wouldn't be any other way you'd be here. And before we start, this is the red laser pointer. And this is the green, which is, it's a little bit temperamental. It's Greek. And many people ask me, how do I spend most of my time during the day at sea? Red dot, green dot. Try to do that. See how hard it is.
Yeah.
Who is steering the ship? Now, the whole section on the Ocean View Cafe with like 20 tables, maybe 100 people, froze. Like, what is going to be my reaction? I mentioned this 1,000,000 times. Do not poke me when I have food. In a civilian environment, he will have one finger broken. On a ship's environment, I stood up and I ran for 5 steps, like he actually got me. And then I came back and I say, it's okay, sir, it's lunchtime. And the entire, I guess, section applauded me, like, really? But true story. Most of what I say come out of true stories. I do not make up stories. Except of sometimes. I have to make up a story. So execution is done by 3 teams of 4 persons every team. 1 chief officer, 1 first officer, 1 second officer, and 1 sailor. Greek, 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 Indonesian. Monitoring comes down to the 3 persons that are in command, myself, the staff captain, and the senior chief officer, which we are daemons, we are not standing watches, and every 4 hours we are visiting the bridge and ensuring that those who are standing watch, they do what they're supposed to do. Plus, we have repeaters of the radars and the monitors on the bridge in our offices, so when we stand in our offices doing paperwork, we can actually watch what they are doing and what they see out there. This is the main steering console. Everything that you see here can steer the ship, except the binoculars here. And I will start one by one explaining to you how it is possible to do it. First, the wheel, or what is left out of the wheel. Many people remember the big, huge, round wheels with the spikes that you need to be Arnold Schwarzenegger to steer the ship. Nowadays, an Indonesian will do. Very, very good job. So, this is the main way of steering the ship. Now, many people say, okay, this is a steering wheel. What if something goes wrong with the steering wheel? Well, second way of steering the ship is by using the azimuth levers. By the way, how do you call it? Lever or lever?
Lever.
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 For me, lever is this here.
Lever. Lever.
Yes, ma'am. You can bear with me with my Greek accent. No problem. So, by moving this lever to red or green, we can turn the vessel equally to port side or starboard side. Have to make sure I say the same things. So this is the second way that we can steer the ship. And again, people will say, what if this doesn't work? We have this little button that is called the mini wheel. It's 2 inches of diameter. And by turning this button to red or green, we can turn the vessel accordingly to port or starboard. What if this doesn't work? We have this little lever here that we call it the DP lever. That means don't push lever. Unless it is absolutely necessary. It is called the dynamic positioning lever that combines 3 bow thrusters. And 2 azimuth propellers and moves the vessel towards the direction we're going to turn this little white dot. What if this doesn't work? Then, very justifiable, we go to NFU. I didn't come up with this acronym. And I know that your first thought is not a pure one. It cracks me up. I'm like this too, you know, whenever something funny comes up, I hear 2 voices in my head. The first is, say it. Go out there and say it. And the second voice says to me, why you haven't said it yet? So as you can appreciate, I can always get myself into troubles very, very easily. NFU means non-follow-up. NFUs. Now, with this little button, from normal steering, we switch it to backup steering, and by the means of this lever, we can steer the vessel when every other mean has failed, with NFUs. Now, what if this doesn't work? We go straight to FU, I'm telling you that. To follow up. Another way to steer the vessel when the speed is less than 9 knots is by means of bow thrusters. That means there are 3 small propellers situated in the front of the ship. Underwater. Underwater. I have people asking me, why can't we see the bow thrusters? All ships' propellers are underwater. Very important to remember. There. Now you can see it because it's on dry dock. Now, this bow thrusters have the ability, when the vessel moves with speeds less than 9 knots, to push the bow around instead of conventional steering the vessel, which is to have the power on the stern and move the stern around so the vessel can turn. So this is another way to steer the ship. What if this doesn't work? Then, when all kind of communication via the wiring of the vessel from the very front high end of the ship to the very aft low end of the propellers, there is hundreds of feet of wire that transfers the orders that we give to the propellers. If this communication is lost, then we have two azimuth rooms right above the azimuth propellers here, and we will have two engineers following instructions from the captain on how to push the azimuth propellers left or right to the tiller switch. Not like that. As I said, the propellers are under the water. Now, I have a... Yes. That was my first reaction to this picture, too.
Goodness me.
The Titanic barely reaches the promenade deck of the Oasis. And the Oasis is like, has given birth to Titanic. Fresh out. How many of you have been on this class, Oasis class? You lose prospect of where you are. Once you enter these ships, you think that you are in a moving amusement park and shopping mall together. The